Welcome guys, how about making a great website and not talking about content, except content, the things that matters most is how you are showing or providing that content. Is it user friendly or not? Web design is all about clear the idea of the user where to go. So today we are going in a responsive web design world. What is responsive web design? Let's look at the definition. Responsive web design is about creating websites which automatically adjust in all devices to look better. For this we use Bootstrap. Why? Well, easy to use, responsive, mobile first approach, blah blah, okay. So today we will make a responsive, well, user friendly web design like this. In the navigation bar we clearly see where to go and the brand logo. Main image, or what we call it, hero image, clearly says where you are. Is it responsive? Well, look how it will look like in mobile devices. Navigation bar items disappeared, but the icon bar button is appeared. Let's click on button. Here is our items. Okay, I hope you got it. What we are going to do? Let's start. First thing, open your Dreamweaver and whatever software you use for web development. Create new HTML file, save it by pressing Ctrl+S somewhere on your computer in the new folder. Write a title. First, we need to know how to use Bootstrap. Here we need three files. Either we can download them or we can directly use the links. By using links, we can't edit these files because they are somewhere on the server. To customize these files, you have to download these files. We will edit only bootstrap.min.css. For others, we are using directly links. Download Bootstrap. Extract it. Put this folder into the same folder as saved HTML. We are going to use the file bootstrap.min.css. This. I hope you know how to use a CSS file in HTML. In the head section, use link tag for external CSS files. Use relation rel is style save. Reference is the path of your CSS file. Type is text CSS. Close the tag. Now write other two files code as a link. Because we are using a server file, so we need internet to load these files. Till now we have done the setup of Bootstrap. Let's make a navigation bar. In the documentation of navigation bar, you can get the idea of what it will look like. There are navbar default and navbar inverse. You can use any one. You can read more about this on this page. Links are given below in the description. Let's use navbar default navigation bar. Copy it from now to now and paste it into HTML body section. These navbar default and container field all are standard and defined in bootstrap.min.css. Define role as navigation. Let's edit the items and add some more. If we see the preview by pressing F12, it's not what we want. We want items in the center, and in the mobile mode it's not working properly. So let's solve these problems. First, let's make the icon bar button for mobile. Define items div tag class as navbar collapse and collapse. Add a button. Instead of this headings, we add a button type button class navbar toggle. Data toggle is collapse. And that a target is navbar collapse. And close tag. Now add 3 icon bar by writing stream class icon bar 3 times and copy paste it. Close the button tag. That's our button. Now solve the center problem. For this we create a new CSS file. Save name style.css inside a new folder named CSS. Now link this file into our HTML. Relation styles it. Reference path of the file. Type text.css. We are using navbar default. That is float value left. We have to change float value to none. That we can do easily, copy it and paste it on your style.css file. Now see the preview by pressing F12. That's working perfectly. But in the mobile mode, I want all these items in the left side like this. So let's put a condition, do it if minimum width is 768px. @ media min width is 768px and close it in a bracket. See preview by pressing F12. Looks good. But I want to customize the navbar text and background. To change the navbar default background, go to bootstrap.min.css and search navbar default. You will find this. Change its colors, value, whatever you like. But if you believe in Google guidelines that can help your designing, go to Google Design Style and Colors. There are standard values of colors that we should use. Try out some colors. I'm going to use easy black and white. Background color value 616161, same for border. Now item specs color. This is how we go to these links navbar default to navbar collapse to now. To list to link. Let's do it. For class we use dot and for id we use hash. So dot navbar default inside this dot navbar collapse inside this dot now to list to link and define style color for text. Write what you like. For spacing margin left 10px and same for margin right and font size 16px. Write whatever value you like. Now let's define hover and focus width for items. Use the same path and the same style for focus. You can define different for both of them. Text color change into slight darker like BD. If you want to change item's background color to, you can define here background color slightly darker than bar background 4 to 4 to 4 to, like this, or whatever you like. Save it and let's see a preview by pressing F12. That's cool, working perfectly. In the next tutorial we will add a hero image like this. A brand logo that will appear in the navigation bar and a hero icon that will appear on the browser bar. If you find it difficult or fast or I miss anything that should be explained more, let me know in the comment section. Feel free to give any suggestions and ask any queries. Thanks for watching. Now it's your time to do it. See you soon in the next tutorial.